Hello and welcome to Tech. I am Mohammed Adnan, and in this video we are going to discuss about how to get the selected previous row value using DAG. It's a real world case and solution in Power BI. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. Now let's get started. So this is the Power BI file. If you look at this value here, here I have date 10th of Jan, 18th Jan, 27th Jan, 6th Feb, and I have selected 18th Jan and 6th February here. If you look at the table now, 18th Jan has 25 value and on 6th February it is 94. On the next column, I have brought up this 25 value here, whereas it has 27th January in between them. The same case, the next I have selected here is 11th of March, it is 49 value. And on the next column, I have brought up this 94 here, that is from 6th of February. Whereas if you look at the slicer, between 6th of February to 11th of March, we have these three dates. But I have taken the value whatever the user has selected. If the user has not selected any of the value, then it is going to fetch the data from the next row as well. So 10th of Jan is 43, 18th of Jan it is 25 and brought up the 43 here. And next it is 27th of Jan, it is 12, it has brought up the value of 18 Jan 25, like the same way it has done. So now let's have a look at the first of all the table structure. This is how the table looks, it's just a plain date and then the value. Now let's have a look at the DAX calculation, what I have used here. The current value, it is just sum of this previous value table, value column, that's it. And the main function starts here. As this function works row by row, so first it is going on the 6th of Feb and it will checking the value. This is a maximum. We have not used less than or equal, we have used less than here. In that case, there is no value available after, I mean before the 6th of February. So it is showing null here. Now it is going to the next row, 24th of February, the value we have selected. So it is taking 24th of February here. And the second time it has only these two values inside this table all selected in this row on 24th February. All selected is only two values, 6th of February and 24th of February. So it is taking the maximum value of the table. It is the maximum here in this case, it is 24th of February. And the previous value it is looking for, right? So the previous value, it is actually the value we have selected is 6th of February. We have this value on 6th of February. So what it is taking? It is taking this 6th of February value in a separate table and it is sorting on a top one value with the descending of this date. Then anyhow it is going to have only one value. So it will take the value of 16th of February, the maximum value of 16th of February available here. So maximum 16th of value available here is 94. So it is taking 94 here. Now again it is going to the third row. Third row it has 19th of March. So here I'm going to change the value here. Here we have 19th of March. So we have three values in this table and 19th of March. So what happened is it is taking all the value, three values in a table and then it is looking for the maximum value, that is 19th of March, which is less than the value is 24th of February. Now we have two values in hand, 24th of February and 6th of February. As you are using this top one value with the value of descending order, so anyway the first date comes is 24th of February. So it is taking the maximum value of this 24th of February to this column. This is how it actually works. Then after that I have used this simple DAG calculation, divide the current row minus previous row, I will get the value and then divided by the current row and then it gives me the percentage. On 24th I have 37 value, on actually the previous value which I selected is 94 and it is less than 150%, and on 19th month we have 62, on 24th it is 37, so it is growth of 40%. And if didn't select anything, then this is going to extract all the value day by day. So this is how you can check the performance of each and every day. So this is how you can able to get the selected row previous value using DAX in Power BI. If you like this video, just click on the big thumbs up button. If you are new to this channel or if you haven't subscribed yet, just click on the subscribe button and also press the bell icon to get the latest notifications. If you have any queries and feedback, just post it on the comment section below. Share it with your friends and colleagues. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. See you in the next video.